Today we're going to discuss the stocking of a brand new pond here in Illinois, one that either is a brand new pond that does not have any fish present in it, or one that has had a winter kill or a summer kill. So we're starting from scratch. In Illinois, our basic stocking is largemouth bass, bluegill, red ear sunfish, and channel catfish. Our initial stocking rate on largemouth bass is 50 to 100 fish per surface acre. We recommend the fingerling size fish to get the proper ratio as they grow. The difference between 50 to 100 is based on the fertility rate of the type of soils where your pond is at. With a lower stocking rate of 50 largemouth bass per acre on more infertile soils, 100 largemouth bass per acre on our more fertile soils. This is a 5 to 8 inch largemouth bass. Sometimes when we're recommending corrective stocking after a fish kill and your bass population has been eliminated, this is a size you can obtain from fish dealers to help get your population balanced. Most of our new ponds in Illinois, we recommend a combination of bluegill and red ear sunfish. And the stocking ratio is as high as 750 bluegills per surface acre and 250 red ear sunfish per acre. And this is also based on fertility of the body of water you're stocking in. And we recommend these fingerling size fish to get the proper ratio as they grow. They will provide the forage for the largemouth bass. This example of a male and female bluegill, once they have become mature, and at this size, and this may occur in your pond as early as the second year, they will be able to spawn, and that spawn will be the forage for the largemouth bass. The initial stocking rate for channel catfish is 100 fingerling per acre for fertile ponds, 50 fingerling per acre for infertile ponds. Channel catfish do not normally maintain a population by natural reproduction in ponds with the presence of bass and bluegill. The pond manager will need supplemental stockings of 8-inch or larger channel catfish in the future to sustain a fishable population. This is a gizzard shad. It is a fish you do not want to stock in a brand new pond. It is a planktivore and it will cause severe problems with your bluegill growth rate. This is a green sunfish, called by many names by many people. Sometimes they call it a rock bass, sometimes they call it a warmouth, but it is a green sunfish and it is another one you do not want to stock in a brand new pond. It does have some orange tipping on the tips of its fins. It is a very tough fish, can withstand very low oxygen and very polluted waters. So oftentimes if you do have poor environmental conditions in your pond and this fish is present, it will survive and it will outcompete the bluegill and red ear sunfish. This is a yellow bass. It is oftentimes misidentified by anglers and people wanting to do their own pond stocking on the side. It is not a good fish to stock in your pond. They usually become stunted at 3 to 6 inches and they will cause severe competition with your largemouth bass population. This is a white crappie. It is also another fish species we do not recommend in small farm ponds, especially on the initial stocking. Everybody likes to eat the crappie. They are extremely reproductive and they become so numerous on their first spawn that they do not obtain a large size. They will become stunted and you will have a pond full of stunted crappies and not a quality fish population. This is a black crappie. It is also another one of the crappie species we do not recommend that you stock in an initial pond stocking. Also extremely reproductive and they will become stunted in your pond and you will not have a quality sport fish population. This is the common carp, introduced from Europe in the late 1800s. This fish is a fish species you definitely do not want to introduce into your pond or allow it to be introduced into your pond. It is a rooter. It digs around in the bottom, disturbs the sediment in the bottom, it disturbs the rooted aquatic plants, and it causes very poor water quality. The water becomes very turbid and it affects the sight feeders such as the bluegill and largemouth bass and red ear sunfish and causes a very poor sport fish population. It competes directly with these fish for food and space. After the initial pond stocking, there are numerous other fish stocking situations that may be used to develop or maintain a sport fishery. However, with these more complex stocking options, it is advised to directly discuss your pond's habitat and your goals with your local district fisheries biologist.